Hey everyone, it's Coach Matt over here at Primal Athlete Training Center, www.primalatc.com. Well, ever since the release of the new ebook a few weeks ago, The Ultimate Off-Season Training Program for Throwers, I have been flooded with a lot of questions regarding training during the off-season and during the in-season. And over the past couple of days, a lot of these questions have come from parents who have younger athletes. We're talking guys and girls that are 6th grade, 7th grade, 8th grade level, that junior high, middle school kind of level, you know, whether that's age, I think that's what, 12 to 14, somewhere in that range. And they're always asking what kind of training program should be done for their son or daughter to get them stronger, get them more explosive, get them in better shape, get them to be better athletes and better throwers. And my answer is always one thing, and that's body weight training. Now, body weight training is something that a lot of people, when they look back at it, they didn't like it. For some reason, it was too tough for them. They were never very good at it. So they went back to using machines and using treadmills and things like that to get in shape. But body weight training, that is the foundation. That is the bedrock, so to speak, that holds up the entire athlete. I have athletes that come in here, freshmen, sophomores in high school, 15, 16 years old, who cannot do a good push-up, who cannot do a proper squat, who do not know how to lunge, who cannot do a pull-up, can't even get their chin halfway over to the bar from full arm's length overhead. And these are the basics. This is the foundation. This is what is going to complement the rest of the training that you do. And for the younger athletes, this is going to be what their training is going to be based around, is body weight training. Now, when we say body weight training, a lot of people think of the basics. And they think of traditional push-ups, they think of traditional pull-ups, they think of squatting, lunging, and things like sit-ups. And yes, those are the basics, but there are a lot of other forms of those movements that you can do. So here's the strategy for setting up for a younger athlete who wants to train 3 days a week with very minimal stuff. As you can tell here in the gym, we have nothing. We have one power rack, one bench, bunch of kettlebells, bunch of dumbbells, a hex bar for deadlifting, a ton of weight, and a lot of homemade stuff. Homemade sandbags, old punching bags that we carry and throw, and a couple sleds. That's it in the glute ham raise. That is it. We have nothing. We have a lot of open space. We have a lot of free space, a lot of usable area, because body weight training is so important to me. So body weight training, guys, to get back on track here, you have to look at, again, Primal Athlete Training Center, you have to look at the 7 primal moving patterns. And that is pushing, pulling, squatting, lunging, bending at the waist, twisting at the waist, and your gait or your walk. So if you can get different body weight movements every day to hit those primal movement patterns, you're going to be in good shape. So the first day, let's say it's Monday, first day, make that your traditional body weight movement. So you've got push-ups and pull-ups, that's the push-pull, body weight squats and lunges, that's the squat and lunge, bending at the waist, that can be a sit-up, twisting at the waist can be some type of a Russian twist, and your gait or your walk could be something like sprints, running uphill, sprinting uphill, sprinting up stadium steps or running upstairs, something along those lines. Now, on Wednesday, 2 days later, take those traditional movements that you did on Monday, make them a little bit harder. So push-ups with your feet up on a chair, that's going to make it tougher. Pull-ups or recline rows, but instead of holding onto the bar, hold onto a towel. Going to make it a lot tougher, going to incorporate a lot of grip. From there, you've got squatting and lunging. Well, instead of doing a traditional squat or a traditional lunge, you can do something like a repeat jumping squat or a walking lunge or a backwards lunge. And for your twisting and your bending at the waist, you can do different types of sit-ups. You can lift items off the ground, whether it's anything that you find around the house. You might have a few dumbbells, a couple heavy gallons of water, a couple of heavy buckets for farmer's walks filled with water. You guys can do any of that stuff. As far as the gait goes, you can do different types of skipping. You can go back to longer distance running, not too long, but you know, if you wanted to go to a track and run one lap, repeat, that would be fine for a younger athlete. And on day three, you can either make it a combo of the easy and hard, or you can step it up even further and make the movements even tougher than that. So, for your push-ups, you can do plyometric push-ups, explosive push-ups, clapping push-ups if your athlete's ready for it. For the pulls, you can do different types of pull-ups and chin-ups, wide grip pull-ups, wide grip chin-ups. You can do pull-ups and release and catch the bar, pull-ups, releasing, catching the bar. That's very difficult, but something that you can try out. You can do different types of squatting challenges, lunge challenges. Make it interesting, make it tough for the younger athletes. You can do different types of running. You can do different types of movements, changing directions. That is going to take the younger athlete and first and foremost, get them in better general physical strength. Get them in a better shape to be a thrower or to be an athlete. But it's also going to get them stronger, it's going to get them moving better, and it's going to get them a lot more explosive. It's going to get them using their body as one total unit and producing more power. You don't need weights. I wouldn't even say an athlete that age should be using a lot of weights. You don't need fancy equipment, fancy machines. You don't need anything like that. If you have your body weight, if you have a couple of homemade things around the house, or maybe a dumbbell here or there, maybe a couple of bands, you are all set and ready to go. That's all you need for younger athletes. Once they master the bodyweight movements, once they're able to bang out 30 push-ups in a row, 15 pull-ups in a row, once they're able to do repeat squatting jumps and get 20 to 30 in a row, once they're able to lunge, say, from the end zone of a football field to the halfway mark of the football field, that's a great distance to do walking lunges. Make up tests. Make it a challenge for the athlete, but keep it body weight. They're going to be able to do it more times during the week. Their body's going to develop a lot better, and they're going to have a great base and a great foundation for when they get to high school, when they get to that 14, 15-year-old range, when they can start really working with weights. Guys, it's Coach Matt. Hopefully you like this answer. I know we've been getting some great feedback. Keep those questions coming in. That's what I'm here for. If you have questions for your athletes, whether it's regarding track and field throwers, jumpers, or sprinters, if you have athletes that do multiple sports or multi-event athletes, keep asking those questions. We've been getting a lot of training questions, and I really do appreciate it. As you can tell, training is my life. That's how I put food on the table for my family. That's how I help out the athletes around this area. I love training. I love working with athletes. So if you have questions, make sure you ask them, and I'll get them answered for you in a future video. Thanks.